When you drive across a bridge, how do you know it's safe? How do you keep this from happening? A Vanderbilt engineer says very special dots may be the solution.
It can see things that we can't see. See degradation happening in these materials.
Slowly, this material starts to break apart. You can see the defect forming before it actually splinters. Tiny quantum dots light up the problem early so it can be fixed.
If the bridge is experiencing a very heavy traffic day, and it's much, much heavier than it's ever experienced before, that might push that bridge beyond a point that it's ever experienced before and might cause a crack to initiate. We'd like that material to know that that's happened, and then when that inspector comes out, we'd like the material to tell that inspector that.
So Vanderbilt researchers devised an early damage light detector, like 1970s color-changing mood rings.
Everybody had mood rings growing up, tells you if you're happy or sad, you know, in love, everything. Why can't we apply this to materials? Why can't we give materials some ability to sense themselves? And we're doing that with these quantum dots through changes in color.
The process begins in Sandra Rosenthal's chemistry lab, working with very tiny nanocrystals.
Another way to describe it is that if you could pick out just one individual hair on your head and divide that 10,000 times, you would be down to a nanometer.
Chemical elements cadmium and selenide are joined to make the quantum dots.
This ultra-small size is achieved by cooling down the reaction very quickly.
After purification, the quantum dots are mixed into a plastic epoxy and light up wherever used. The material is tested in Vanderbilt's laser engineering lab. This time, it's coated on the surface of fiberglass bars. Before damage begins, the white light slowly dims, invisible to the human eye. But a laser beam catches the minute changes before the fiberglass actually breaks.
We are at the point where we've demonstrated in surface coatings, we've demonstrated in bulk materials, the ability to observe this material's self-reporting capability.
This work that we're doing with Doug Adams is actually the first time that we've explored those broad-spectrum white light nanocrystals in a sensing application.
Vanderbilt researchers hope self-reporting materials like these will one day help make bridges, planes, and even power plants safer for everyone. For ViewCast, I'm Barb Kramer.